Reinventing an icon is a bit like reinventing the wheel. Where would you even start? More to the point, how on earth do you duplicate a vehicle that's perhaps the world's most recognizable, let alone improve on it? Even Volkswagen admits they misfired with the second generation car, or New Beetle. It was too hippie, too dippy, too simply formed, and too childlike. The follow-up to one of the most wildly successful cars in history was too one-note. It evoked the feelings held in some baby boomers' minds relating to the first bug in the late 1960s, and that's it. What then makes a third-gen Beetle? More cues from the original, that's what. Taken in from the side, it's the new Beetle more attractive, it's more mature. And if you believe Volkswagen's marketing machine, more masculine too. While the new car is quite evolved, sure, they copy the wheels, but in a smart way. Most subtle and impressive of all might just be the design Easter eggs found in the rear tail lamps. Look closely, and you'll see that they're taken from the upright shape of the 1967 Bug's taillight assembly, but rotated 90 degrees. Laying them down like this helps to both widen and lower the car, all the while keeping part of the original spirit alive.